Good morning to everyone. In this video, I am going to explain about Hamiltonian cycle. Hamiltonian cycle means we have to start at one place. We have to visit all the vertices of a given graph at least only one time. Then at last we have to reach the starting position. So here, in order to trace each and every travel of visiting each and every vertices will be represented by a tree that is called as state space tree. So for example, if I created four nodes A, B, C, D, assume that all the nodes have been connected with each other. So first I will create a root node, that is A. From A, I have to think of what are the possible ways to reach out all other vertices of a given graph. So from A, either I can visit B or I can visit C or I can visit D. Then afterwards, from B, I have to think what are the adjacent vertices of B. So I have to travel through the adjacent vertices. At last, the condition here is after visiting the adjacent vertices of all other vertices, again I have to return back to start position. That is the main concept of this Hamiltonian cycle. Cycle means starting at one place, visiting all other places, then terminating at the same starting place. That is called as Hamiltonian cycle. So this is what I have explained. Now I am using utility set scanner. The Hamiltonian as a class name. First I'll get adjacency matrix as an input. Adjacency matrix means it has set of rows and columns where most probably we will assign all the diagonal element as 0, provided if we assign any value for the diagonal element, then there will be a self loop. So we have to avoid such a thing. So in order to avoid the self loop, we have to assign all the diagonal element as 0. If there is any edge carry some weight between one vertex to another vertex, then in the corresponding rows and columns of an adjacency matrix, we have to write it the corresponding value. So here I am getting the number of nodes. So using scan.nextin, we will get it everything. And if we are creating the adjacency matrix, we need to get two-dimensional matrix. So I represents rows, J represents columns. So by using the two different for loop, we will get the adjacency matrix values. Then public void next vertex of int k, which means that, as I said before, first we have to start at one place, then we have to identify the adjacency vertexes of a starting vertex. Then if there is any direct edge existing, then we have to choose those vertex. So until it becomes true, we have to keep on compute the adjacency vertices by x of k equal to x of k plus 1 modulus n plus 1. We know the number of vertices, so that will be assigned for n. If so, modulus operation will be performed with divided by n plus 1. So if the value is 0, then we have to the value need to be written. Otherwise, we have to compute the next adjacency vertices of a given graph. So here, if x of k, j is equal to x of k, then we have to complete. Otherwise, if j is equal to k, then again we have to check the condition k is less than n. K is less than n means that it must be less than the number of vertices, as well as either this condition need to be satisfied or the adjacency matrix value should be reached to 1. So if those things occur, then we have to return the corresponding value. Next I am writing the Hamiltonian function. So until it becomes true, we have to keep on search the next vertex of a given graph. So if it is everything completed, then the value will be assigned to 0. Then at finally we have to identify the path from the source vertex to all other vertex. At last it has to reach the starting position. So that need to be displayed here. Then under the main function, we will call that Hamiltonian function, which is already explained. So this is an output. So now, what are the possible ways to reach out the source after visiting all other places that will be displayed at here. So this is all about the program. Now I'll explain, execute the program. Number of nodes, 3 nodes I'll give. Adjacency matrix, as I said before, the diagonal element should be 0. So 0, 1, 2, 1, 0, 3, 3, 4, 0.